Hi. Can I help you? Wait, wait, wait. No, please.
Teresa's ally? Okay, so next we will be discussing Alex's outline. So who would like to begin? Mary?
So one of the things that didn't really work for me was your goal to use montage to try and introduce this hitman character, whatever his name was, Dante. Right, anyways, I think that if you find like a different way to tell this story, I think we might get a better idea of who your protagonist is and like what his intentions are.
Thanks, Mary. I appreciate it.
Anyone else? Yeah, Dominick, go ahead.
Yeah, so I think your idea is straight fire, you know? And I admire your ambition. But I just feel like the lonely and depressed hitman is a kind of character that we've seen before. You know, it's a trope. But if you kind of take your story and forge it into your own, I think it could really work.
Interesting. Yeah. Thank you, Dominick. I actually appreciate that. Thanks, I'll take note of it.
Great. Anybody
Can
else?
Can I add something?
Yeah.
Alex, I know it's just an outline, but to be honest, I just think there are too many components here. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love your work. It's just, I think sometimes you just try to do too much, you know? And it's not always a bad thing, but I think for a short film it is. Try thinking of something personal. Narrow down the scope and take it from there.
Anybody else? Well, thank you, everybody. Alex, I do want to give you some final notes before we move on. I do think that this outline is a little bit too much for a short form story, and that Hitman character story is a little familiar. I agree with what Teresa said. Channel something personal. You know, your thesis should define you as a filmmaker and as a storyteller.
Thanks for the feedback, everyone. Pretty much agree with everything that was said. I really do. I just have certain ideas in my head that I'm passionate about. And some of those ideas may be seen as tropey, or some of those ideas may be seen as unoriginal, but hopefully with the way I see it and the way that I plan on executing it, that it could be a breath of fresh air. And you know, if it's bad, if it's not good, then I'll still be happy knowing that I tried.
Alex? Hey, wait up. Alex. Alex, wait up, please.
What do you want now?
Don't be frustrated with me, Alex.
Frustrated with you? You say you love my work, and then you just completely reject my idea. How can I not be frustrated with you?
I was just trying to help you. Like everyone else in there was just trying to help.
I mean, I just feel like no one believes in me but myself.
I believe in you. And it's just an outline, Alex. Try thinking about what everyone else was saying and, you know, start from there.
You're right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be frustrated with you. You're always right, so. Yeah, like, sorry.
It's okay.
Thanks. Appreciate it. All right,
Yeah. I have to go.
All right.
I'll see you later.
All right, I'll catch you later.
When's the Lord of the Rings watch party?
Finish the script first, then we'll talk.
All right.
Guess I got what I deserve. Kept you waiting there too long, my love. All that time. Thank you.
Seems like you're missing the letter N here.
Can't let them take control, Alex. Unoriginal? Trope? Come on.
It's going to be so good.
See you tomorrow.
Son, good to see you.
Care if I join you, son? A beautiful night.
It's been a while since I've been out of the city. It's nice.
I guess that means you're sleeping over.
We'll see. We'll see.
What's going on, son? Something seems off.
Yeah. I just don't feel like myself.
put too much pressure on yourself. You support yourself, you live in your own apartment, you have a job, and you're graduating in a few months.
Yeah, but I barely get by. Nothing is guaranteed after I graduate. Just wake up every day so unhappy. And then when I'm finally passionate about something, it just gets stripped away from me.
What got stripped away, hon?
My dream. My vision. And my confidence. I had to submit a pitch for my thesis idea. Let's just say that did not go well. Practically got rejected.
Even if you don't agree with what was stated, you have to listen to what they said. As you know, in this business, you can't be stubborn.
Is it stubbornness or is it pride? You know, I finally generated an idea. I saw the whole thing in my head. I reignited my passion and I just couldn't wait to show the world, you know, what I could create. And I got shot down. I was told to make it more personal. And I have to go straight to work a job that I hate just to pay bills. Then back to my empty apartment just to do more work. And then a class every day to see the woman I love, but she has a boyfriend. Rinse and repeat. How the fuck am I supposed to generate a new idea when I have to live through the same pain every single fucking day?
It sounds a lot like life to me, son.
So what do I do?
I'm sure you will do the right thing.
I guess I just don't know what the right thing is anymore. I'm stuck in free fall and I just don't know what to hold on to before hitting the ground.
You have a vision. You took a risk. Grow from the rejection. You have the passion. Use the pain in your film. And most of all, you're so creative. Use your creativity. You got this, son. And no matter what, we love you and we support you in everything that you do.
Love you too, Mom.
Think you could tell heaven from hell, blue skies from pain? Can you tell a green field from a cold steel rail, a smile from a veil? Do you think you can tell? Walk on part in the wall for a leap. wish you were here.